California's iconic sequoias are the largest trees on Earth. These giants have lived for thousands of years, surviving war, famine, and the rise of globalization. But California's ongoing drought could mean disaster. These enormous trees are already showing signs of weakness never seen before. Anthony Ambrose and a team of researchers are heading into the forest to climb hundreds of feet in the air and see what can be done to save these magnificent trees.
Our research entails climbing the giant sequoia trees and measuring their water status, basically an index of how stressed they are relative to the environment. The water status of all plants is kind of like the equivalent of blood pressure in a human. It's just a basic measure of how much water they have available to them to continue to function and grow. So we clip little shoots of foliage and we put the little piece of foliage leaf end down into this pressurized chamber, and the amount of pressure it takes to push the water back out of the stem is equal to the amount of tension it was under when you cut that piece of foliage. When water availability declines, such as during a drought, that creates a lot more tension in the tree. When the tension becomes too great, then tiny little air bubbles form in the wood, and when it gets bad enough, then the plant suffers and starts to die. There's a couple reasons why we need to climb to the tops of these trees. As water moves up the tree, it's fighting gravity and friction, and the top of the tree is going to be the most stressed part of the tree. So in order to get a really good idea of how stressed they are, we need to go to the very tippy top. It's a really humbling experience because you're up in the crown of these massive ancient things and they make you feel small. I'm at the top of a very large giant sequoia tree. We're waiting for the sunrise because it's really, really pretty this morning. It's important to realize and remember that these trees have been living for thousands of years and they've dealt with pretty severe events, fires and droughts in the past, and they're amazingly resilient. One of the things that really is remarkable about these trees is their ability to recover from drought-type events. The question is, as conditions change, as temperatures continue to increase globally, are conditions going to change to a point where they may reach some threshold where they're not able to recover from these type of events? It's an absolutely amazing, unique experience to be able to climb into these trees. We want to preserve them. We want them to be here, and we want them to be healthy and happy.